Good morning, everyone. Let us start this session. So this is lecture number 12. During the last lecture, we were discussing about the types of load. So we have seen the different loads, point load, then UDL and UVL. So we have seen how to convert the distributed load or the varying load into a point load. Okay. So today in this session, we will discuss about the types of support. So the first type for the support, it is called as a hinge support. So hinge support, it offers two reactions. And it will allow the rotation. Okay, so you can observe in the given figure, this beam AB, or we can say a rod AB, is supported by using the hinge support. Okay, so this is the representation of the hinge support. So this is hinge support, okay, or it is also called as a hinge joint. Okay, so what is meaning of it allows the rotation? So this hinge support will offer two reactions, one in the vertical direction and second in the horizontal direction, and it will allow the rotation. That means if you apply some force on the beam AB, okay, suppose this is F, then effect of this force will be, it will create the rotation of the beam AB. Okay, so that you can observe here. So this is the effect. That means this hinge support, it will allow the rotation, but it will offer two reactions at the joint. So these two reactions one reaction will act exactly in the vertical direction. So this is VA, and second reaction acts in the horizontal direction. So this is HA. So when we draw the free body diagram for this beam AB, so this is the beam AB. Then at point A, as this is hinge joint, we will show the two reactions. One is VA and second is the HA. Okay, so this is the representation or the free body diagram for the hinge joint. So the practical application you can see in the first picture. So this is the bridge, okay, and this bridge is supported by using this hinge joint. So this is the hinge joint, okay. So at this point we will have two reactions. So this will be the vertical reaction, this is VA, and there will be horizontal reaction, that is the HA. Okay, so second type of joint or the support is the roller support. So roller support, it offers one reaction which is perpendicular to the surface on which the roller is mounted. So it offers one reaction and it will allow the free movement of the object or beam, which is supported by using roller support. So it allows free movement of the object. Okay, so you can observe, this is the schematic representation. So this is a roller support. Okay, so you can observe here, these are the rollers. So this is just a representation. So this is the fixed surface. So this can be a ground. Okay, and this is the object which is supported by using this roller support. So let us take this as a beam. So this is point A, and suppose this is B. So this beam AB is supported at point A by using the roller support. Okay, so the reaction which is offered by this roller support, it will be perpendicular to this surface on which roller is mounted. Okay, and it will pass through this point, and it will act exactly at point A. So this is representation is RA. Okay, so RA is the support reaction which is offered by the roller support on the beam AB at point A. So when we connect the roller support to any object, okay, like a beam, then it will allow the free movement in the horizontal direction or in the vertical direction. Okay, so you can observe here, as the point A is supported by using roller support, and suppose we apply some force on the beam AB in the horizontal direction. Okay, so this roller support will not offer any resistance to the applied force F. So as there is no resistance, that means there will be movement of the beam AB in the positive X direction. Okay, so this is the free movement. Okay, that means it will not offer any resistance to horizontal motion. So when we draw the free body diagram, for the beam AB, at point A, just show one reaction, which is RA. Okay, so this is representation of the roller support, and this is the free body diagram. So this is the practical application for the roller support. So this is again a beam which is used for the construction of the bridge, and this beam is supported by using the roller support. So this is the roller support, and this is the part of the beam. Okay, so at this point, roller support will offer the reaction. So this is the reaction. Suppose this is RA. Okay, and this RA reaction will be perpendicular to this surface on which roller is mounted. So this is the horizontal surface. So when we draw the free body diagram, this is the free body diagram. Okay, so generally roller supports, they are used in the construction of the bridge to allow the thermal expansion for the beams. So you can observe here, so this gap is provided between the two sections of the bridge so that it will allow the thermal expansion. And to allow the thermal expansion, we use the roller support so that there can be free movement of this bridge. Okay. So these are the support reactions. So I hope this roller support is clear. How to represent the roller support? And the third support, it is the fixed support. So fixed support, it will offer three reactions. And it will not allow any type of movement. Okay, so you can observe this is the I-beam. Okay, and this I-beam is fixed in this wall. So this will form a fixed support. That means this beam, it cannot rotate. Or if you try to pull this beam in the horizontal direction, okay, then it will offer the resistance. So we cannot pull this beam from this support, okay. And also if we apply the force in the upward direction, okay, it will offer the reaction in the downward direction. Okay, so this beam is fixed to the wall. It is represented as, suppose this is the wall, and this is the beam AB. Okay, so this fixed support, it will offer two reactions which are similar to the hinge support. So one reaction will be vertical. So this is VA. Suppose this point is A and this is B. Second reaction is horizontal reaction. So this is HA. And additional to HA and VA, there will be one more reaction, which is moment reaction. Okay. So moment reaction, we can visualize by considering one force at point B. So suppose we apply one force at point B, suppose its magnitude, it is equal to 20 Newton. Okay. And B point, it is at distance 2 meter with respect to point A, which is the fixed point. Okay. So if this is a hinge joint, okay, then it will offer only two reactions, VA and HA. Okay. But it will allow the rotation of the beam AB. That means when we apply the force 20 Newton at point B, the complete beam AB, it will rotate about the point A, as there is no restriction or no resistance to the applied moment by 20 Newton. Okay. But in case of hinge fixed joint or fixed support, this fixed support will offer the counter moment to the moment which is applied by 20 Newton. Okay. So right now this moment value is 20 into 2, that is 40 Newton meter. And what is the sense of rotation about the point A? This 20 Newton will try to rotate the complete beam AB in the clockwise direction. Okay. So in order to maintain the equilibrium, that means exactly horizontal position, there has to be one counter moment, which will be in the anti-clockwise direction. Okay. So this counter moment is given by this fixed support. Okay. So in this way, it will offer three reactions. One is HA, second is VA, and this counter moment is represented as MA. Okay. So for fixed support, we have HA, VA, and the moment MA. So these are the three reactions offered by the fixed support. Okay. So suppose we have two spheres. Like this, okay. and this is the contact point for these two sphere. And these spheres, they are supported by using the horizontal plane, inclined planes like this. Okay, so when you solve this problem or perform the force analysis to find out the reactions at the supports, we need to consider that support as a smooth support. Okay, so here we can observe the contact points. So this is the first contact point. This is contact point between two sphere, okay, and this is contact point between sphere and the inclined surface. So suppose we isolate the sphere 2 and if you draw the free body diagram, okay, so in the free body diagram, the first force, it is the self weight, it will pass through the center of gravity. So this is the W. Okay, then at the contact point 3, there will be one reaction. So this is the smooth contact. So this reaction, it is similar to the roller support, that is, there is only one reaction. So this is reaction R3. Okay, and this direction we can get from this geometry. So this reaction R3 will be perpendicular to this surface. So this is 90 degree, okay, and it will pass through the center point of that sphere. Okay, so if this is the tangent line, okay, then this will be the perpendicular. So similarly at point 2, so this is the contact point 2, okay, the reaction at contact point 2 will be common reaction for sphere 1 and sphere 2. So when you draw the free body diagram, the direction of that contact reaction will be like this. Okay, so this is the reaction R2. This reaction will also pass through the center point. Okay, and this direction will be, if this is a tangent line, okay, this will be the perpendicular. So this is the reaction R2. Okay, so similarly for this sphere 1, okay, so this common reaction R2 will be same, its direction will be opposite. Okay, and again it will pass through the center point of the first sphere, and this direction will be, it will be perpendicular to this tangent line. Okay, then at point 1, this is the reaction. Okay, this reaction will be perpendicular to this inclined surface. So basically this inclined surface, it is tangent to this sphere. So this is the tangent line and this is perpendicular. Again it will pass through the center point and there will be self weight which will act in the negative y direction. Okay, so this is called as a smooth support. Basically, it is similar to the roller support. It will offer only one reaction. Okay, so similarly, we can use this smooth support. So we can take the second example. Suppose the ladder is resting against a wall and on a horizontal floor. Okay, so this is the ladder. So this is just a schematic representation. Okay, so this is the wall and this is the ground. So when you draw the free body diagram for the force analysis, this smooth contact, so this is the smooth surface and this is also smooth surface. So at the point A and B, we will show the reactions. So this is the free body diagram. Okay, so at this point reaction will be like this. So this is exactly in the horizontal direction. So let us take this as a RA. So why this is horizontal? Because the contact point, the surface is exactly vertical. Okay, and therefore this reaction at point A will be perpendicular to the vertical surface. Similarly, at point B, this is the contact reaction. Okay, and this reaction is perpendicular to the horizontal surface. So this is the reaction at point B. So this is the RB. Okay, so that means for the smooth support or for the roller support, the reaction will be perpendicular to the surface on which the roller is mounted. Okay, so I hope the smooth support and roller support is clear. So now we will solve one problem on the support reactions and the types of load. Okay, so here the beam ABCD is supported by using a UDL point load and the UVL. Okay, so you can observe here the UDL has a value 10 newton per meter, then UVL is 20 newton per meter, and the point load is 50 newton. Okay, so this beam ABCD is supported at point B and at point C. So the support at point B, it is the hinge support, and at point C, it is the roller support. Okay, so this roller is not exactly horizontal, it is inclined by angle 30 degree. Okay, and question is, we have to find out the support reactions at point B and C so that the given system, it is in the equilibrium. Okay, so when we solve the problem for the equilibrium, our first step will be draw the free body diagram. Okay, so for the free body diagram, the object on which the forces are acting, okay, this object is nothing but the beam ABCD. So draw the beam ABCD. That means we need to isolate the beam ABCD from its surrounding. Okay, so this is the beam ABCD. Okay, so this is point A, this is B. Now first step is show the point load as it is. So 50 newton will be as it is at point D. Now remaining two loads, one is UDL. So here 10 newton per meter, this is the uniformly distributed load. Okay, and this 20 newton per meter, this is the maximum intensity for the uniformly varying load. So we need to convert the UDL and the UVL into point load. Okay, so you can refer the formula for the conversion. So this UDL, its point load will act exactly at the center of the AB. So suppose this is the center point. So this is the point of application for the point load of the UDL. So we can consider this value as F1. It is equal to, so how to convert UDL into point load? Multiply UDL by its length. Okay, so this lengths are, this is 1 meter, this is 2 meter, this is 1 meter, and this is 3 meter. Okay, so F1 will act at 0.5 distance from point A or 0.5 distance from point B. F1 value is 10 into span is 1. So this is equal to 10 newton. Similarly, convert the uniformly varying load into the point load. So this is the 90 degree angle. Okay, so point load, it will act somewhere here. Its distance from this 90 degree this is equal to L by 3. So L is 3 meter. So this will be L by 3. So it is 1 meter. Okay. And this value will be F2, that is equal to 1 by 2, base is 3, into height, that is the maximum intensity is 20. Okay. So this is equal to 30 Newton. Okay. So this is 30 Newton. Then we have to show the support reactions. Okay. So point B, it is the hinge support. So we know the reactions at point B. B will offer two reactions. One is vertical reaction, that is a VB, and second will be horizontal reaction. So this is the HB. Okay. So right now we don't know the exact direction of HB. Okay. So we can assume it is on the positive X side, or you can assume it is on the negative X side. So right now I have assumed HB is acting in the positive X direction. Okay. So when we solve the problem, that is a force analysis, then we will get the exact direction of HB. Suppose from the calculation, we get the HB as a negative, then we will correct the direction and actual direction will be on the negative X side. Okay. Now consider the point C. At point C, it is the roller support. So roller support, it will offer one reaction. So this reaction at point C, it is perpendicular to this surface. Okay. So we will show this vector like this. This is the direction. Okay. And it is perpendicular to the surface on which roller is mounted. So we can show the reaction at point C in this way. Okay. So this is reaction RC. So we need to decide the angle with respect to X direction. Okay. So this angle is 30 degree. This is 90 degree. So this remaining angle, it will be 90 minus 30. So this is equal to 60 degree. Okay. So this is angle 60 degree. So this is complete free body diagram for the given beam ABCD. For the FBD, we show the point load as it is. So this is 50 Newton. Okay. Then convert UDL into point load. Then convert UVL into the point load. Okay. And then show the reactions for hinge support. There are two reactions, VB, HB. And for roller support, there is one reaction, RC. Okay. So is it clear to you how to draw the free body diagram?